all consider equations of the type where in the time derivative we have a measurable function that is in the graph of the derivative convex function with respect to first variable. And in the diffusive term, we have a monotone operator in the first argument.
Sorry.
And the physically, the relation graph represents the capture the evolution of the free boundary between two phases. And the diffusive term control the temperature variation in space. The function F represents the heat source or sink. And we have the standard Stefan problem when our monotone operator is linear in the first variable, and the function F depends only the variable X and T. So in order to have the existence property, we need to put some basic hypothesis in the functions F, alpha, and phi. The condition alpha is it must be convex, lower semi-continuous, and the graph of its derivative must be between two cones. Our monotone operator must be continuous in its first two variables. Its graph must be at most linear in the first variable, less than linear in the second one. Must satisfy this cohesive condition, and this condition is necessary if our function f depends on the derivative of temperature. We also need a notion of the weak solution in the condition our function f is similar to alpha. This notion of the weak solution is formulated in the framework of Sobolev space. So a function u is said to be a weak solution of our problem if there exists a function W in the space L2 such that is belong to the differential of convex function, and it must satisfy the differential part in the sense of distribution. So with this condition and this notion of weak solution, we have that we have a existence of a weak solution. But we don't have the uniqueness property unless the one of the functions of phi and alpha is linear in the first argument. In this case, we have the uniqueness. Here, our main concern in this talk is the following homogenization problem. Here, the variable z represents our oscillator variable, and the functions phi, alpha, and f that depends on the z satisfy the C condition uniformly in z. So the first result in that direction in the periodic case was given by Dalamian, that where he considered its subdifferential as a graph of the following type. And its monotone operator was linear in the first argument. A more complete result, also in periodic case, was given by Augusto Vicentin in 2007. Where he proved that the sex of weak solution U epsilon strongly converges to a function U that satisfies a similar system that independent of Z. So when you see that problem in a more general set, you note that his method is strongly based in the equivalence between LP convergence e LP convergence. And this equivalence only happens in the periodic case. Here, I'll present an extension of his results in a more general ergodic algebra. So For this, we need to put remember some basic concepts. The first of them is the concept of algebra with mean value. And algebra of function is an algebra with mean value if it's invariant with respect to translations. Must be bounded. We must be closed with respect to the uniform approximation. Its element in A must be uniformly continuous, bounded, and has a mean value. That means these limits exist. So the generalized Bezukhovich space is the closure of the set A with respect to the semi-norm. This space is a Bezukhovich space with this scalar product. And another important concept for us here is the concept of ergodic algebra. An algebra with mean value is ergodic if any function belongs to correspondent Bezukhovich space B2 that is equivalent to its translations, and that means that must be a constant in the sense of B2. Here, we have some examples, some basic examples of ergodic algebra. The more classical is the set of periodic functions with fixed periods. The next example is the set of almost periodic functions. That is the set of functions whose the set of translation is precompact. And the Fourier stage algebra, that is the closure of the set of functions whose Fourier transform is a complex measure. And the set of weak almost periodic functions, that is the set of functions whose set of translation is weakly precompact. So we have that inclusions where each inclusion is strict, right? Another intrinsic property of algebra with mean value is that it can be seen as the algebra of continuous functions over a compact set K. The mean value is an integral in that compact set K with respect to a probability measure, M. And the Bezukhovich space is equivalent to space L2. Another important concept for us is the concept of algebra with mean value, with value in a Banach space. Given a Banach space E, this space is defined by the set of functions with value in E that are bounded, uniformly continuous, and the set of its projection belongs to algebra A. In the set of bounded projections is relatively compact in A. So, as in the real case, we have the set A, I, N, E, and the set of continuous functions with value E are equivalent. We can define the analogous Bezukhovich space with value in E as completation of the algebra with mean value with vector value. Completation of this set with respect to this semi-norm. The same can be made with the space L2. And due to the equivalence of this set in any set, we have that new spaces are equivalent to. So here we have, here we have an important tool for our homogenization procedure. Here we have a function PC that satisfies some conditions. The first condition is convexity in lower semi-continuity. The next, the function psi deve satisfy this condition is necessary for you allow the discontinuity in the variable X in oscillatory test function. That function must, its growth must be no at most quadratic and must be bounded below by a parabolic function where coefficients belong in appropriate Bezukhovich space. So, with a function like that, we have the following theorem. If you have a sinus of function in space L2 that is uniformly bounded, you have that exists a Fermilab probability measure, where we have the following sub-representation. Here, the family of measure, we call two-scale Young measure. In that family of measure was introduced first by in periodic case for solving nonlinear problems by E and Serre, in non-periodic set by Hermano and Ambrosio. And see, if you have that function is uniformly integral in omega, we have the right-hand side converge to the left-hand side. So in immediate application of this theorem is in the following convergence. If you say that a sinus U epsilon in space L2 to scale converge to U, if you have this limit for all test functions in this space. So an interesting compactness result is that any bounded sequence in space L2, we have that there exists a subsequence that has a two-scale limit. And that scale limit is characterized by this equality. So if you have a function that two-scale converge to a function U, by our previous theorem, we have that integral in omega, dpsi U epsilon, X over epsilon, X dx, limite inferior, is less than integral in omega, integral in k, the measure nu xt, dz, dx. And, sorry, I forget, psi, z in x. And by just inequality, we have that is greater than integral in omega, psi, u, z, x, z, x, dz, dx. So this inequality is fundamental for us to conclude that weak convergence is into a strong convergence. Right? So if you combine, if you put this inequality together with some important facts. So, see, if this function satisfies this regularity condition in an inequality like that for appropriate, for any some strictly convex function phi that satisfies that condition, we have that strong convergence. So here, but you put together this inequality with this. So we have this strong convergence. And another important fact here is if you have as bullet sequence in this space, so you have that it has a two-scalar limit. But if you bounded in some sublevel space, you have that two-scalar limit doesn't depend on the oscillatory variable. So we need some important spaces here. This space B potential is the set of vector fields that satisfies this equality. And similarly, we define the spaces B2, so the set of vector fields whose divergence is zero in the sense of B2. And if you take the vector fields whose mean value is zero in this space in then another space, we have the following orthogonal decomposition if your algebra is ergodic. So in another interesting property of this space that use that orthogonal decomposition is that if you have a Bolo sequence in this space, that we know that unless a subsequence, we have that U epsilon weak converges to a function U in this space. And its gradient, that bounded in the normal 2, has a two-scalar limit. Due to this data composition, we can decompose the two-scalar limit as a sum of gradient of this weak limit with a vector field that is potential. So aqui we have a homogeneized potentials and we define this functional that was introduced by Vicentin in the periodic case. And here the function psi satisfies some condition. The first condition is convexity, must satisfy this regularity condition, and must be low by a quadratic function. So with these conditions, if a psi satisfies this condition, we have this theorem. If you have, let o epsilon be a family of weak solution of this problem, where our monotone operator is a subdifferential of the convex function psi, and along a suitable sequence, U epsilon strongly converges to a function U that satisfies this system, this limit system. Here we have the idea of the proof. You take Q epsilon by this function, and F epsilon by this, and using these conditions and we obtain these estimates uniformly in epsilon. And because of bounded in the space L2, each of them has a two-scalar limit, and we obtain this weak convergence in the sense of L2, where bar means the mean value of the correspondent function in the oscillatory variable. So we have the function U, W barra, Q barra, and F barra. What's the relation among of them? Using the weak formulation for U epsilon, and take the limit as epsilon goes to zero, we have that weak formulation. So, due to the bounded uniform in this space, and we obtain a sequence uniform in epsilon, that, and if you use the result compactness do it album, we have this strong convergence in this space, so we can deduce this limit holds, and the function U satisfies this inequality. So by our previous theorem, we have that U, this function, this sequence of function U epsilon strongly converge in L1 to U. Double ZXD belong to this differential. And the correspondent mean value belong to the differential, the mean value of the of psi in the variable Z. So if you use the strong convergence U of U epsilon to U, you have that the two scale limits of Q epsilon is in this space B2 solid. And you can prove that limit holds. So if you use the monotonicity of the monotone operator alpha, this inequality holds for our test function phi. And due to strong convergence of U epsilon to U, you can exchange U epsilon by U, and this fact allow you to take the limit in both sides and conclude that inequality. That inequality holds for all test function phi, and by maximal monotonicity of alpha with respect to first variable, you can conclude that Q belongs to the differential of the convex function psi. And so his mean value belongs to the differential, subdifferential of the functional psi zero, where psi zero is defined by this. So moment. And this concludes our proof. Here, we give an application to a porous medium equation. We consider the following equation where gamma is positive, and our matrix satisfies this condition, and it is bounded. If you introduce this variable in defining this function phi, we have that equivalent formulation of our homogenization problem. So due to our homogenization of Stefan problem, we have that following theorem. For each epsilon, the unique solution V epsilon strongly converges to a function V that satisfies that equation. So, is it?